Space Cats, and welcome back to my channel. US President Donald Trump has just initiated the US Space Command.
We're gathered here in the Rose Garden to establish the United States Space Command. It's a big deal.
Ultimately, with its eyes set on the US Space Force. But does that mean that the days of Star Wars are soon to be upon us? Hopefully not. But this week, I'm going to be talking about modern day space warfare. The US Space Command, or US Space Com as it's called, is a command within the US Department of Defense. It's not something new. Actually, it previously existed between 1985 and 2002, and its role back then was to coordinate the use of outer space by the US Armed Forces. US Space Com and US Space Force are two completely independent identities. The US Space Force will become the sixth branch of the United States Armed Forces, and its role will be to organize, train, and equip the Space Forces. Whereas the US Space Command will employ assigned forces from within various military services to carry out missions specifically in the space domain, and they will specifically focus on two aspects. Firstly is the protection and defense of threats against the US space capabilities, and secondly, to maintain and grow the space programs. Each day, we're becoming more and more reliant on space technology. From GPS navigation to direct our cars and our airplanes, to weather satellites and global disaster monitoring, communication satellites provide us our TV, our radio, and our internet. And we are becoming more and more reliant on this space technology. It's an increasing asset that humans cannot live without, so it's very natural that we would want to protect it. In 2007, China conducted an anti-satellite missile test. This projectile absolutely destroyed a weather satellite at 900 kilometers altitude from the ground. Now, China has been an advocate of banning space weaponry, and they've publicly stated that they would never participate in any outer space arms race. However, as of right now, there are four countries that have the capabilities of these anti-satellite weaponry, and these are the US, China, Russia, and India. Anti-satellite weaponry are dangerous. As recently as earlier this year, India showed they could test an anti-satellite missile, and this test resulted in a huge amount of space debris that posed a threat to the International Space Station and all of the astronauts on board. The biggest worry is that missiles like this will produce shrapnel that will go on and collide with working telescopes, working satellites, and other space debris, causing a cascade of space junk. There is a huge amount of space debris in space already, and it's really difficult to monitor it all. Some are very large chunks of metal, while some can be very small particles that are equally as dangerous because of the high speeds they're traveling at. Use of anti-satellite missiles will only add to the already overfilled space junkyard. But thankfully, space is large enough that collisions between space debris and space satellites do not occur very often. It's still very important, however, that we monitor the traffic in space, or else there could be dire consequences. For example, earlier this week, ESA's Aeolus satellite had to perform an emergency maneuver to narrowly avoid a collision with one of SpaceX's Starlink satellites. Since 1957, over 9,000 satellites have been sent into space, and of these, about 2,000 or so are currently still operational. That's at least of which we know of. Military spy satellites are typically kept under top secrecy. For example, NASA recently received a donation of 2 satellites. These were originally military spy satellites that were built in the 1990s, but then were superseded by newer technology, making them obsolete to the military. To the astronomical community, however, they are far superior than the current state-of-the-art telescopes that we have, for example, the optical space telescope Hubble. Nobody owns space, so it's very difficult to establish who is responsible for clearing the space debris. It also means that there's no rules about the space traffic. The Outer Space Treaty was established in 1967, and 109 countries have signed it to ensure that no nuclear weapons will be used in outer space, no country can own any celestial body, and the exploration of such should be used for peaceful purposes only. So we shouldn't fear any space war just yet. Even though Russia recently sent gun-wielding robot Fedor to the International Space Station, we are still a long way off space army and lightsaber wars. Another big threat to space satellites, however, is cybersecurity. Cyber hacking has already become a serious crime here on Earth, but cyber hacking a space satellite could be devastating. For example, if we had fake GPS signals going out, it would cause chaos for air traffic control and for cars. Also, piracy, data protection, and fraud are also big concerns. Ultimately, space technology has become so important these days that having protection protocols in place is not such a silly idea. So there you go, those were some obvious roles that a US Space Force would be involved in. Thank you for watching this week's video. Let me know in the comments section below what space technology you couldn't live without. And as usual, if you enjoyed the video, make sure you like, share, and subscribe.